Don't argue with me, I have a knife in my hand.
Take three couples.
Thank you, darling.
Who love to entertain?
Look at this!
Ask each pair to throw a dinner party.
You want me to take the curry away from me off your plate?
Leave that on your plate. If you don't like it, don't eat it.
And get them to score each other in secret.
We're 16 or 17.
Today, there's conflict in the kitchen.
Get your hands off my apple pie.
And tension at the table.
Do you think maybe he just doesn't love you then?
I think Jackie's been a lot more outspoken tonight, and I think perhaps she's actually trying to be a bit provocative with what she's saying.
As each pair compete to win a £1,000 prize.
I feel like a guinea pig now.
Today on Couples Come Dine With Me, we're in Southend, where the first ever wedding to be held on its pier ended in a brawl. Hoping their night ends better is our first couple, 49-year-old Dan and his 47-year-old partner Jackie, who met in a bar 3 years ago.
Snog my face off in a car park.
I did not snog. I didn't jump on it.
Yeah, you did.
Don't listen to him. I didn't jump on him.
And it's not just the details of their first encounter that this pair don't see eye to eye on.
For me, without a doubt, it's about presentation, much more important than taste.
No, I disagree. You can have something that's slightly poor presentation, but the taste will be unbelievable.
No, sweetie, you're wrong.
Fortunately, Dan's doing most of the cooking today, kicking off with his starter, cheese and onion temptation.
Beautiful. Like it's got my name all over it, that,
like
babe.
That, babe.
Love cheese and onion.
Yep.
But I want cheese. Cheese.
Cheese. You want to know that
the cheese is there.
In sync in every possible way, our second couple, 25-year-old Hannah and 32-year-old Lucy, who both work for a local MP.
Oh, too cute!
I would describe our relationship as perfect. We live together, we work together, we spend all of our spare time together, and it's awesome. I can't get enough of her.
Oh.
We would sicken other people with our relationship.
Yeah.
We do that. It's sickening, isn't it?
A little bit. Back in the kitchen, Dan's cracking on.
The starter is a caramelised onion and goat cheese tart.
Do you want to bite on a spoon?
And what?
Bite on a spoon.
Bite on a spoon.
Yeah, no. I saw it on telly. It stops you crying.
No.
Just trying to help.
Not much helping so far. Dan then adds brown sugar to onions, along with butter, olive oil and balsamic vinegar, and leaves to sweat.
And that's it. That's done.
Next, on to the pastry.
Can't use that tin, sweetie.
Why?
I need that tin for my dish.
No, this is definitely the tin I use.
Yeah, but I need that one.
Well, you can't have it.
But I need that one.
Well, that's
can't tough. You use another one?
No.
Can't you use a pretty round one?
No.
Tray finally decided on.
So this is where my presentation skills come in, laying him daintily on the little pastry tray.
Well done. Dan carefully tops with pesto and the caramelised onion.
Oh, that one's sticking out a bit, honey. We need to push it in a bit more.
Shut up.
He adds goat's cheese, brushes with egg, and...
voila, they're done.
He'll cook before serving, so it's on to dessert. Tempting tart with a surprise drizzle.
A surprise drizzle. Wow.
There's a little problem with desserts because I don't eat sweets. But I will do an effort and I will try each dessert, I promise.
That's fine, because... if there's anything on there that I don't like, you can eat it and I'll do the desserts.
Meet our third and final couple, 50-year-old kitesurfing instructor Simon and his 35-year-old Polish-born girlfriend, Edita.
Too close, that's it. I describe our relationship as fun, adventurous and sporty.
Slow it down a little bit.
I would say that our relationship is rocky, sometimes up, sometimes down. But that's life. One of my good friends used to told me that if the relationship is not rocky, it means that it's a dead relationship. So our is pretty alive.
Can I have a bit of a more interesting job to do?
No. It's a necessity.
Back with the first hosts, and relations are alive and well, as Dan's given Jackie the task of peeling apples for his tempting tart.
Darling, you've messed that right up.
My dessert is the French classic tatin. The surprise drizzle is a nice vanilla cream.
Dan then gives Jackie a lesson in making caramel by heating sugar, water and butter.
Should it be bubbling like that?
Yep.
And how do you know when it burns?
because it will go very dark.
Wouldn't it be easy just to buy it ready-made? I mean, I can't believe, you know, we're sitting here watching a frying pan with caramel in it bubbling away. Mm. I mean, what a waste of time.
It's not a waste of time, it's cooking.
In actual fact, do you know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of, like, an omelette now.
It's not an omelette, darling, it's sugar.
But it looks like an egg omelette, doesn't it?
No, it looks like sugar.
Looks like an omelette to me.
Can I put the apples in now?
Caramel done, it's Jackie's turn to shine.
I've done a really good job here. I mean, you've, like, melted a bit of sugar in the saucepan, but I've actually done all the, like, artistic bit. Look, I've done really well. I'm really proud of myself. Oh, right, what do I do with it now?
Do you want the polite answer? It gets hot enough. And flushed with success, the tables are about to be turned as Jackie's in charge of the main course.
OK, God.
The perfect breast!
With bits and bobs.
I'm hoping that's going to be the food and not the hostess.
Oh, Simon.
That's going to... I'm
serving you up, are they, babe?
No, they're not. It's actually chicken breast, stuffed with spinach and ricotta cheese.
I need you to peel those two potatoes, sweetie. Now, honey, you have to peel them horizontally. That's it. Make sure you get all the little eyes out and the little brown bits.
Horizontally?
Yeah, horizontally. Loving bossing them around. Oh, thank you. Right, now I need you to get rid of the potato peelings.
Oh, I think you've annoyed your sous chef.
Now, sweetie, could you just cut these carrots now? I want the carrots, like, cut into kind of Juliet-type pieces, but they need to all be the same length and thickness because it's all about the presentation.
Got that, Dan.
I was expecting couples, as in married couples or couples like ourselves, but now I'm actually thinking that it could be something completely wacky, two friends or...
Wacky?
Are those carrots all the same length and width?
No.
I think late 30s.
Yeah, around our age range.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or late 30s. Maybe in my 30s yet, babe.
Oh, should have known that. Jackie then finishes by wrapping in Parma ham.
Very good presentation. Well done.
Prep done, and after a quick change, they're ready for their guests. And first couple to the door, it's Hannah and Lucy.
Hi, come in. Hello, Jackie. How are you?
Hi, Hannah.
Hi, nice to meet you.
I'm Jackie. Lucy. Hi, Lucy, come in. Hi, can I get a drink?
Yes, please.
What
would
you like?
Red wine.
So, who is it?
We have Lucy and... Yeah. Oh, my God, I've forgotten her partner's name.
You've forgotten? Their names, or
I remember Lucy. I've forgotten the other one's name. Oh my God. Hi. This is Dan. This is my partner.
That's not yours.
There you go. This is Lucy.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Thank you.
And this is.
Hannah.
And this is Hannah.
Hi, Hannah.
Yeah, got away with that one.
Very bubbly welcome. And very warm welcome.
I keep saying to Dan, don't I? I keep saying I want to colour my hair. And he keeps going, no. But I love it. Well, see, now you've seen it on someone, honey, do you think that it would suit me?
I don't know. Maybe.
Maybe?
Why'd you put me on the spot with the hair thing?
Because I think their hair colour is really nice. I really like it, and I've been trying to persuade you.
What if I said, no, sorry, I don't like it? She's got that hair colour.
But do you like it?
Yeah, it's all right.
So I can have my hair dyed that colour now?
Last in, it's international duo Simon and Adita.
Hello, Jacob. How are you?
Not very well. How are you?
Come in, what's your name?
Adita.
Adita,
and
come
I'm
in.
Simon.
Hi, Simon, come in. Come
nice
in.
To meet you.
Come in.
Hello.
Hi,
I'm Dan.
Adita.
Hello, Anita. Adita.
Think about
Hello.
Eddie and then hand it up top.
Adita. Hi, I'm Dan, I'm Simon. Hi, Simon, I won't kiss you.
Do you think they are a couple?
No, he met her on the street last night. Of course they're a couple.
Dad, you can't say that. Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
A really
Cheers.
Nice
Cheers.
Evening.
Cheers.
Come on, give it a go.
Oh, coming up.
Babe, you're ruffling it.
Couple confusion.
Hannah and Lucy are a couple.
But they could be flatmates.
Yeah. Darling, they are couples.
Model mayhem.
Look at his own legs.
And dangerous dinners.
Bang.
Yeah.
That is what
Bang.
This is going to do.
Punch in the mouth.
Punch in the mouth.
Yeah.
Night one in Southend, where three couples are competing to throw the best dinner party.
What's on the top of the black?
Caviar.
Caviar,
darling. And tonight's hosts, Dan and Jackie, are hoping to impress their rivals with some fine dining.
Cheers!
While Dan cracks on with his starter, Simon and Adita are left to their own devices.
Make sure you don't spill anything on the carpet.
I'll never spill, but you do not spit with the red wine in your mouth.
And Hannah and Lucy have a look round upstairs.
Come on.
Give it a go.
Babe, you're rougher than it.
It's ever so hard.
Well, I'm not even joking. This is the most uncomfortable position I've been in.
I feel like I'm giving birth.
Why would you?
Sitting up like this.
One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
They have a lot of cushions.
A lot of cushions.
A lot of cushions.
Seven.
Seven. Eight. Nine.
Ten. 11. 12.
12 cushions on one bed.
That's 12. Not counting the seven that were on the chaise lounge at the end of the bed.
Yeah.
That's a lot of cushions in one room.
19 cushions in one room.
And 6 tarts ready to serve.
I think it looks really nice, honey.
Thank you. I'm really proud of those.
Dan's cheese and onion temptation.
This is a special wine for today.
Can we do something interesting here? Because Adita actually went on a wine course.
Did you?
Oh, brilliant. So, let's see what it is.
I think it's Sauvignon Blanc with Chardonnay mix. It's definitely old world. So it must be somewhere France, Italy or Europe.
Well, it's a Pinot from Marlborough, New Zealand.
Yes! Chardonnay, Sauvignon Blanc. Out of what European countries were they?
Blend.
And it was a Pinot Grigio from like New Zealand.
Leave the poor girl alone.
I know.
She got it wrong.
She's lovely. She's just crap at wines.
Frankly, though, that was Simon's fault for putting her in the line of fire.
It was.
She's done a wine tasting course. What do you think?
Yeah, tell
I mean, he did put her on the spot a little bit, didn't he?
He did.
You've not done very well, but you know.
They're testing me on everything, OK? I feel like a guinea pig now.
Humiliation over, it's on to the food.
I have to say, it was absolutely delicious.
Oh, we're really glad you enjoyed
you.
It. Absolutely.
Well, there's a good start.
Fantastic.
Isn't it, darling?
It was very good. I enjoyed it. And it was goat's cheese. Normally you don't like goat's cheese, but you ate it. Enjoyed it?
I did enjoy it.
Doesn't normally like goat's cheese.
We went and had a look upstairs, and you have a lot of cushions.
Do you think?
You've got 12 cushions on your bed.
12?
You actually counted them?
Yeah, counted them.
We did count them.
Mm-hmm. This is the cushion queen.
Oh,
I told you.
It's 12 a lot, then?
You don't think there's a lot of cushions?
No, I think
you need to have cushion therapy, darling.
The amount of cushions that we have in this house is normal.
I can't believe at a dinner party we're talking about cushions.
I hear you. Back to the food, and after a good start for Dan, it's Jackie's turn with the main.
Looking good.
The perfect breast with bits and bobs.
Can I just say, presentation, amazing.
Thank you. Hopefully you all like chicken.
Yes, absolutely.
Is that what it is?
Right, the main course, it was cooked really well. It was really, really nice, but it was a little bit like a Christmas dinner.
Jackie, please don't hate me for this one, but carrots and beans were raw. Crunchy as crunchy can they be.
What have we got in the chicken?
Okay, so the chicken spinach, definitely some cheese is there.
There is. Do you know what cheese? Ricotta?
I think it's ricotta, yeah.
Well done, girl!
Oh.
Absolutely perfect. Spinach and ricotta.
You should become a food expert, not a wine expert.
Yeah.
And Hannah, she got the cheese. Are you kind of a foodie person in kind of your household?
Yes.
Do you do the food?
Yes, I do the food.
Do you do most of the cooking as well, then?
Mostly. Lucy chips in.
Does she?
Hannah and Lucy are a couple.
But they could be flatmates.
Darling, they are couples.
Do you think?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
You could just ask them.
How long have you two been a couple then? How long have you been together?
Nearly 2.5 years.
So I was saying to Jackie, we had a bit of a chat about it.
And friends?
She said, that's exactly what I said. She said, no, they could be friends.
They could
be housemates. And I went, no, there's too much chemistry between these two girls.
Yeah, exactly. We picked up on it straight away.
We give off something, which is something we've heard before, that we give off a vibe of sorts. But I think Jackie was probably just being a bit polite.
I told you Hannah and Lucy were a couple.
Okay, I got it wrong.
You guys were working really well as a team back in the kitchen. How long have you been together?
About 2 weeks.
Fortnight.
That's the same thing.
Yeah, fortnight.
No. We've been together 3.5 years.
I was sort of surprised that they'd only been with each other 3.5 years because
they seem to have gelled as a couple, that they've been getting out with each other for a few decades.
And now it's Simon and Adita's turn to be probed.
Where did you two guys meet?
I was his student when I went to kitesurfing classes.
Adita phoned me up and said, me and my friend want to come down. Now, normally you book it. And I just went, are you and your boyfriend? And she went, no, me and my friend. And I went, all right, see you in about 2 hours. So she came down for a lesson. And I taught them privately, just her and a friend. And we just hit it off.
When he was telling us about how he met Adita and what he does, it was interesting to begin with, but it did kind of go on a little bit.
She asked for directions to the local pub. And I said, if you carry on walking that way, you'll be fine.
You know, why use 100 words when you can use 10? I met Adita kite surfing. Job done. Not, you know, War and Peace. I've kind of dropped off by then.
Luckily, Jackie's got a Play-Doh party game to liven things up.
OK, guys, we're now going to play a little table game. You need to make an image of someone at the table. Go!
I was able to use Adita's glasses as my main point on my purple man.
Purple man?
Purple woman figure!
Oops.
So you all have to guess who this is.
Simon!
No.
Are you sure?
Oh, actually, yes. Yes! Adita, let's see your one. Okay, who do people think this is?
Dan, so, I think Dan.
You think Dan?
No, it's a Simon. Look at his short legs.
It was this girl, short legs, yeah. Other than that, it's all right.
It was spot on.
We'll talk about that one later.
Adita.
It was hilarious. And when she said Simon short legs.
Yeah!
Unbelievably good.
So far our night's been really good. It's been good a lot. Look, I mean, people have been laughing a lot, so that's always a good indication whether you're having a good night or a bad night. I think the food's been good enough. We've just got sweet to go.
And after 20 minutes in the oven.
I think it looks okay. It all depends on the flip.
I'm watching the flip. Go for the flip. Oh my god.
Oh, I can see how you wooed her. Here's Dan's tempting tart with a surprise drizzle.
I do not eat sweet for the last 10 years.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you know what, Dan, you should be really proud. This girl was not eating dessert for 10 years and she ate your dessert tonight.
Yeah.
Why? I will tell you why. Because it's not too sweet, it's not too sticky, it's just perfect. Combination of this one, which is not sweet at all, which is sour cream with whatever mixture that.
Sweet expert.
I don't
vanilla.
Know.
Vanilla pods.
So what was in the surprise drizzle, Dan?
The vanilla pods.
Oh!
All right, each couple need to score out of 20.
The dessert was nice. The apple and the cream mixed all together. It was well-balanced flavours. And it was nice.
We'd score ourselves...
18.
Wow. 17, 18.
Either a 7 or an 8, personally, I would give them.
I would say the same, so I think we should split down the middle.
16 or 17.
So we give them 15.
And our score tonight is 16.
So that gives Dan and Jackie a score of 31 out of 40 with 2 nights to go.
Oh. Well done. Well done, darling.
I know, it's all about me.
I don't think so.
It's day 2 in Southend, and the turn of Hannah and Lucy to host. And not surprisingly, they're doing everything together.
I think we're a brilliant team. The best team.
But it seems last night's hosts, Dan and Jackie, are far more interested in Simon and Adita.
I don't think Simon's got any control over Adita whatsoever.
No. I think she definitely wears the trousers, don't you?
Absolutely.
Everyone normally falls in love with Adita. I can be a bit of an awkward one, I suppose, to guess.
Yeah, let them know already.
She just does her own thing.
And she says exactly what she thinks.
And she's kind of just pulling him along behind her, isn't she?
She's a little bit like you in that fact that you don't think before you speak and you just say what you think.
And on that note, it's back to the kitchen where Hannah and Lucy are planning to wow their guests with a night of flavoursome food, kicking off with a starter of broccoli and Stilton soup.
Oh, I do like that. That's nice.
Brilliant. I love soups.
Yeah.
I can live off soup, so
I can go with that. That's quite nice.
Hannah and Lucy start by chopping onions, potatoes and broccoli.
Try and get the florets at the same sort of size, darling, so that they cook at the same rate.
Hello, trouble in paradise.
Are you happy with the size of the florets?
I'm delighted.
Thank you, darling.
Well done.
Then they boil the veg and add stock, and it's onto the Stilton cheese.
Not a great fan of soups generally, to be honest with you. And not a great fan of Stilton in soup because it can be quite strong.
We often say that we don't like ingredients to whisper, you know.
You want it.
I am Stilton, I'm in your
you
soup.
Don't want
I'm there. No.
No.
I am Stilton, I'm in your soup, I'm in your mouth, bang. Yeah. That is what this
bang.
Is going to
punch
do.
In the mouth.
Punch in the mouth.
Yeah.
Oliver?
Yep. Obviously take the rind off. Is it?
Cheese chopped, Hannah blends the soup before adding creme fraiche and melting in the Stilton. Punchy enough?
Oh, that is delicious. Lovely.
Lovely job.
Boom. Beautiful.
Starter's done, it's on to dessert. Chocolate cake, served with a raspberry coulis.
Chocolate cake, always a winner.
That's a really good safe choice. Who doesn't like chocolate?
Everybody loves chocolate. This dessert is the ultimate chocolate cake. It is rich, the chocolate is so intense. It's not for the light-hearted, you know. You don't come here on a diet. This chocolate cake is phenomenal.
After smashing the chocolate, Hannah and Lucy melt it in butter, then add coffee.
This might seem a bit strange, but it adds an extra layer of richness.
They then combine carefully measured quantities of flour, cocoa powder and sugar.
A bit more, babe.
Is it?
I think Lucy's role will be more the hospitality side of it.
Only a bit more.
Shut up.
Probably being bossed around about Hannah, a bit like you were with me yesterday.
I did boss you around.
Darling, you did boss me around a little bit.
With Hannah and Lucy, there's two women living in the house, so you'd expect it to be clean, wouldn't you? Two women, you know.
Well, you might.
Oh, babe, there's a bit of elbow grease.
The cake mix is then poured into a greased tin and left to bake.
Top, babe?
Yep.
Once cooled, they'll coat with a ganache and serve with a raspberry coulis.
I'm very sticky.
It's all right.
So it's on to the main course, slow roast pork belly.
That is one of Dan's favourite dishes. Probably not so much me, again. Mm. But you would love that if that's cooked right, wouldn't you?
If it's slow roast, and it's definitely slow roast, so the fat is gone, it's lovely. It's crispy and it's gorgeous.
This has been marinating overnight. We're adding some more lemon to it now. It's going to be cooked long and slow, and it's going to have the best crackling they've ever had.
Cracking!
To be honest, I don't think we could have done any more to secure a victory today. We've pulled out all the stops.
All the stops have been pulled out.
Everything, we've done everything we could have done.
There's still more to come. Still more stops to go.
And maybe some dancing?
Yeah.
That's it, we're done.
Come on!
Ups, top.
Fun.
Dancing complete, there's time for a quick change before the couples arrive.
Babe, final stop, let's do this. Boom!
First to the door, it's last night's hosts, Dan and Jackie.
Hello! Oh, lovely to see you.
You too. Oh.
Are you well?
I'm good.
And you? So, are you enjoying the bubbles?
We are. Really nice. Good.
Really nice. Good. Thank you very much.
It's gagging for a glass, actually.
Next, it's wine expert Adita and short leg Simon.
Hello. Lovely to see you.
Good to see you again. How are you?
Hi. Hello.
Adita. Lovely to see you.
How are you doing?
Hi. Lovely to see you again.
Guys, cheers. Here's to Mel, too.
Cheers.
Coming up, an awkward moment.
Do you love Adita?
Yeah.
What, really love her?
A hairy moment.
2006, I have hair right down my back.
You had a mullet.
I don't think they're really interested in what we do. 10 Downing Street. Not a flicker.
Not a flicker. Purple hair. Conversation.
Yeah, conversation.
And a windy moment.
What's the smell? Are you farting?
No. Wouldn't do that.
Guys, cheers.
It's night two in Southend, and the turn of partners Hannah and Lucy to see if they have the skills to beat two rival couples and bag the grand.
We've done everything we can to hopefully give the guests a fantastic evening. We are very excited.
Very excited. We're in it to win it. Good luck.
Good luck.
While Hannah and Lucy get on with the starter, Jackie and Adita have left their men behind to go exploring.
It's 10 Downing Street.
Yeah. That must be this Christmas. Oh, it's not this Christmas because she doesn't have red hair.
Why do you think it's Christmas?
Because the Christmas tree next to him?
Bit of a giveaway.
God, yeah, I didn't see the Christmas tree. Oh, my God. Yes, yes. Perhaps it was a Christmas party they went to 10 Downing Street for.
There is a picture of a Christmas tree and she just went, oh, after the third time, it's a Christmas tree. Yes, it is.
Thank you.
The 10 Downing Street is the street which is going from Big Ben to Trafalgar Square.
No, Trafalgar Square is like the big square in the middle with all the kind of little signs that go up the top
the
of
street,
it.
The street which is going from Big Ben to Trafalgar Square.
Doesn't Trafalgar Square have, is it Eros on it, the statue? With no, the steps, with the fountains.
That's Piccadilly Circus.
Oh, is that Piccadilly? Oh, God, OK.
Which one of you was born in England again?
So where do you think it is now?
I think it's in Downing Street, next to number 8.
It is in London, in Downing Street, in Westminster.
Time to get your laughing chops around Hannah and Lucy's starter, broccoli and Stilton soup.
So, who created the soup?
I created the soup. I have about 8 different ones that I make on a rotation, and Lucy's kind of done a top of the pops of the soups.
I rank them.
Sorry?
This is number 1.
This is number 1.
Broccoli and Stilton
is number 1.
I have
to say. It's good. Yeah, it's lovely. Beautiful soup. I like this broccoli and Stilton soup. It wasn't a lot of it, but it was a nice starter.
Soups generally are not something I would go for. And I was worried about the Stilton would be quite overpowering. But I have to say, guys, actually, you've done really well.
I think it's overdone with the cheese and the soup doesn't, consistency of the soup is not a soup, it's actually cake.
What?
So the picture upstairs on 10 Downing Street. What have you been doing there?
Okay. Well, because we work for a Member of Parliament, there was a meeting at Downing Street and we were asked to go along.
Was it this Christmas?
No, that was Christmas 2011.
I knew it.
How did you know it wasn't this Christmas then?
Because of your hair.
What hair colour did you have prior?
Blonde. Brown with blonde highlights, yeah.
All right.
I don't think they're really interested in what we do. 10 Downing Street, not a flicker.
Purple hair. Conversation.
Yeah, conversation.
2006, so I had hair right down my back.
No, you had a mullet?
No, it's just like long hair. Cake, surfy.
Wow, awful. Sorry!
Don't hold back, Jackie.
Apparently he had
blonde hair, and dyed
blonde hair.
Until Adita got hold of him.
I'm not surprised. And then he went grey. Are we not surprised with that?
Oh, charming.
Look at that.
Main next, and after 4 hours in the oven, Hannah and Lucy's pork belly is ready to serve.
Beautiful, babe.
Babe, get a spoon, tap the crackling.
Yeah, babe, go on.
Oh,
that
is the sound of perfect crackle.
That is the crackling of stars.
Yes.
And here it is, slow roast pork belly with roasted veg and a splash of jus.
It can't be a raspberry jus by any chance.
It's a red wine jus.
A red wine jus.
Yeah.
I think that the dish was delivered really well. The flavours complemented each other. And I think the girls really cooked the pork excellently.
You enjoying the crackling, Adita?
I love it.
The pork belly cracklings, I love it. This is my favourite things. I don't have to eat the meat, but I will eat the crackling. And I think it was spot on. It was gorgeous.
Have the pepper back again. Is there a bunch of...
The main thing wasn't great, if I'm honest. The crackling was just far too sugary and sweet for me and kind of stuck to my teeth, to be honest. And the pork was far too stringy.
Back at the table, talk turns to those three little words.
Do you tell each other you love each other all the time?
Dan tells me he loves me all the time, don't you, honey?
Oh, that's lovely.
You don't. You send me texts. His little saying is, when I do say to him, I love you, he'll always say, I love you more.
What about you guys?
I mean, I do what I think is a romantic gesture every now and again. Put the seat down or something.
So does it bother you that Simon's not very romantic?
Oh, yes, occasionally driving me mad.
Really? Yeah. Do you wish
you've never mentioned it.
We made a deal that once a day he's telling me I love you. So whenever I would say, Simon, I love you.
I'll get it out of the way pretty quick. Yeah, I love you. That's it.
I don't think just saying to someone once a day that you love them is a declaration that actually you love them. So I think kind of
Aditya set herself up for a fall.
Do you think maybe he just doesn't love you then?
You can't say that!
Maybe.
Well, now everybody will know that.
I think Jackie's been a lot more outspoken tonight. I think because it's not her dinner party, she's not so much standing on ceremony, and I think perhaps she's actually trying to be a bit provocative with what she's saying.
Do you love Aditya?
Yeah.
What, really love her?
Yeah, really love her.
In love with her?
Yeah.
So why don't you tell her you love her then?
With most guys, you don't need to do that. I don't need that. So I don't think other people
but
do.
But don't you think she needs it?
Yeah, I don't think it's really about you.
It's not about you. That's a selfish view. It's about what she needs and what makes her feel secure and loved. And that's you telling her
and
that
cherished.
You love her.
I've always been the way I am, you know. And that's just me. I don't suppose I'm going to change overnight.
Well, maybe this will sweeten you up a bit.
I am making initials in the raspberry coulis for our guests, so they've got a personalised plate for their dessert.
Yep, it's Hannah and Lucy's chocolate cake with a personalised raspberry coulis.
Oh, yes, here we go. Dessert. Lovely.
Oh, thank you.
Wow.
Hey, Jay! Look at this!
See if you can guess the mystery ingredient in your coulis.
Is it amaretto?
Amaretto.
Yes, well amaretto. Done.
Good. Can I just ask, where's the amaretto? Is it in the red stripe thing or the chocolate cake?
It, when you say red stripe, that's your initial, that's a J. And it's in your
J. J for Jackie.
I don't know what my name is. No, it is Jackie.
I wondered.
Okay, it's like...
It would be a lot easier to write, though, if it was just J, wouldn't it? Mm.
Taxi?
Considering this one, the Radon is sweet, Lizette was lovely, and I really liked the sauce, the red sauce, what they made it. However, I didn't eat the cake because I just didn't eat sweet.
Dan's an absolute chocoholic, but I'm kind of, give me a couple of spoonfuls, that's enough.
That why you didn't eat it?
That's why I didn't eat it, I know.
Overall, our night, I don't think we could have done any more. We've pulled out all the stops. We have bent over backwards, and I hope they recognise that.
Okay, I would go 13, and I can say the reasons why I think it's 13.
No, I think it's 15.
They cooked the pork belly to perfection. And they just got the edge over Jackie and Dan, and tonight we're giving them 17.
We're going to give the girls a fairly big score of
14.
And that means that Hannah and Lucy are level pegging with Dan and Jackie on 31 out of 40.
Yeah.
I love you.
It's the third and final day in Southend, and tonight's hosts, Simon and Aditya, are hoping to scoop the £1,000 prize with a night of international fare.
The two previous nights have been fairly safe. English-based menus, but fairly straightforward. We're going to push the boat out a little bit. We're going around the world. They went a little bit safe, both of them, but we're opening it up.
The food might have been safe, but so far the conversation has been anything but. Right, Jackie?
Every time I think of them, they just make me laugh, Aditya and Simon. I think Simon tolerates Aditya.
I think last night we saw the real Jackie. I don't think Jackie's afraid of asking questions. She knows what she's asking and she wants the answer to the question, but I don't think she's really bothered whether it's an appropriate question to ask in the first place.
What's the smell? Are you farting?
No, wouldn't do that. Rambo. Oh, he's playing the dog.
Hopefully any smells can be disguised with Simon and Aditya's cooking. First stop on their world tour menu is a Thai-inspired main course of pad Thai with giant prawns and red Thai chicken curry.
We love a curry.
Love a curry.
And I love a Thai curry.
Not a lover of spicy foods. I'm hoping it's not too spicy. I will try some.
This is where the risk element comes in. I can overdo it with the chilies.
Simon begins with his red Thai chicken curry, for which he makes a paste out of chilli, garlic, ginger, tomato puree, spices and sugar.
Less is more with a curry. Always remember that. I'm going to get some water in there because that hasn't really worked too well.
Let's not overdo it, less is more.
No, a little bit more.
Oh, now it's looking like it's supposed to.
That's more. Yeah, it looks good. Well, there's no going back now.
That's a punishment they're going to have us all.
We might come third, but we'll have the last laugh.
Simon fries the chicken in a lot of onions. Oh, He then adds the potent curry paste and coconut milk and leaves to simmer.
Don't argue with me, I have a knife in my hand.
You got that, Simon. He'll make the pad thai before serving, so it's on to dessert.
What are you doing now?
I want a bowl for the apples.
Okay.
Easy. And with a little help from Adita, Simon will be making a British classic of homemade apple pie and custard.
Well, I love apple pie, so, and I love custard.
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 If that is not homemade, I will be disappointed.
Thumbs down for that.
Best put your thumbs up, girls.
This is the first time that I've tried to make fresh custard, so I've actually am a little bit worried.
Under Adita's watchful eyes, Simon mixes milk, sugar, cream and vanilla.
You stir that for me.
How long?
6 inches.
Boom, boom!
I think Adita's going to be playing sous chef to Simon today. I think he's very much going to be the person in control in the kitchen.
How long do you want me to stir?
Simon. Simon. It has asked you a question. What, Simon. Oh, never mind.
Whoa. No, that ain't going to work. All right, we'll take that off.
And so much for the gadgets.
Yeah.
Simon then whisks egg yolks and combines with the warm milk before returning it to Adita's capable hands.
If this doesn't go well, I've now got someone I can blame.
I could use to.
Oh, OK. Right. Keep stirring, keep stirring, keep stirring.
Not sure that there'll be a team ethic there so much. They're pretty feisty.
Look, you started getting lumps in now.
But I was telling.
No, you didn't. You can't stop stirring. Right. Let's just leave it at that. You've got the lumps in it, and I'm going to get them out.
I don't think they will always agree on how things should happen in the kitchen.
I would agree with you, darling.
Harmonious, nice.
Lump free. How about that?
And after saving the day, Simon moves on to the apple pie. He cooks apples in sugar, whizzes up pastry.
That's how that's supposed to look like?
I hope so.
And finally assembles.
I couldn't have got that any better if I'd have tried. He must have done it before. Then, oh no.
Not sure you've done that bit before.
Never done that before.
I just said that.
Irritating person, you. I love you so much.
Dessert done, it's off to the sklep.
OK, Simon, basically, you're going inside and you're buying Włoszczyzna.
Włoszczyzna.
Macaron na rosół.
Macaron na rosół.
I kostki rosołowe drobiowe.
Yeah, I got that.
Right, this should be interesting.
Hiya. I'm going to make a rosół soup tonight. Have you got macaron na rosół?
Yes,
thank you.
I'm proud of you, well done.
Thank you.
Your Polish is getting very better.
Perfect, thank you very much.
Ah, noodles.
The rosół, the cubes.
Stock cubes.
What needed?
Włoszczyzna.
Which one?
This one will be fine. And, Włoszczyzna. Włoszczyzna.
Yes, they have it.
Now it's like a veg.
I'm proud of you. You're probably getting much better.
Oh, imagine what it used to be like. And sklepping down, it's back home to put the ingredients to use in Adita's starter, which is Polish rosol soup.
Polish soup?
Yeah, I think, isn't that the traditional one, Polish soup?
It's
Adita cooking.
If I'm right, I think it's made with Polish sausage and it's got some vegetables in there.
Well, actually, Hannah...
This Polish chicken noodle soup, which is called rosół.
Adita starts by cooking chicken and boiling veg.
To make a nice colour onto the rosół, you need to fry the onion and make it brown. Did you know that?
No, I didn't.
Uh-huh.
When I do it, I cook the chicken in the frying pan with the onion and then I put it in the soup, so I do things my own way, but same sort of result.
No, it's not, Simon.
It'd better be better than mine.
It will be.
Because I don't blame you. Yeah, that's a winner. Well done.
Woohoo! And cooking complete, there's time for a quick change.
Come on, Adia, our guests are just about to arrive.
He's not wrong, here are Hannah and Lucy.
Hello!
Hey, welcome! In you come.
Hello.
Well, nice to see you again.
You too. Hello, lovely to see you.
Nice to see you. In you go. Yeah.
Ladies,
that's been so nice.
For the good start. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Followed closely by Dan and Jackie.
Hello!
How are you doing?
How are you?
Good.
Hi, girls.
Hello.
Oh,
no.
Sorry, how
man.
Are you? Cheers. Yeah, yeah. To another great evening.
Great. Yeah, to another great evening. Brilliant.
Coming up.
Show me the money.
Two confident cooks.
Show me the money.
One disgruntled diner.
You want me to take the curry away from off your plate?
Yeah. Would you mind?
Yeah, that's not a problem.
Me, probably the worst main of the whole week.
And the winning couple is revealed.
Yay!
It's the third and final night in Southend.
Cheers!
And Simon and Adita are hoping to out-host their two rival couples and win the £1,000 prize.
I don't suppose any of them have had a Rosol Polish soup before.
Time to find out. Here's Adita's Polish Rosol soup.
I've had it before when I've been in Poland, and so has Jack, actually. When we saw it, we said...
We've actually had this.
The problem is, Adita, is that we said, obviously being Polish, since being a traditional Polish dish, that we would have expected to be... This would be like a bacon sandwich to the English, and it should be absolute perfection.
Yeah.
Check it out now.
It seems to me that sometimes Jackie looks for things to pick on to make other people look bad.
Would this soup knock one of your top 10 off of its slot? Would it get into your top 10 soups?
I don't think I could make it the way that Adita makes it.
I think... Adita executed the soup really well. I think I absolutely loved it.
For me, that should have been absolutely exceptional, but I just thought that the chicken could have been done differently.
I liked it. It was inoffensive, but it didn't wow me.
I will just say that's my first ever Polish dish, and I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Lovely.
It was flavourful, but it's not the soup I like. I do not like broth-esque soup.
I think it went down well. Yeah, so far I think we're doing really well.
So it's on to the main. And while the chicken curry warms, Simon whips up pad thai noodles with soy sauce, spring onion, chilli jam and egg.
I've just got to wait for the prawns now, and hopefully we're on the money shot. Show me the money, show me the money.
Here's Simon's pad thai served with giant prawns and a red Thai chicken curry.
Can I just... Because it's not... Is it not red?
She's off again.
If you make it with a paste, then it comes out a little bit redder, probably through food colourings and stuff.
Oh, OK.
But when you make it a little bit more natural, it's harder to get it to be bright
because
red.
Because the chilli actually can make it a red colour.
Does anybody want this? I can hardly touch
it. Oh, thanks,
sir.
Do you want me to
take
the curry away from off your plate?
Would you mind?
Yeah, that's
sorry.
Not
just, someone else would probably appreciate it.
No, it's not
a problem. Let me just take a prawn, and I'll have one spring roll as well.
Cool, excellent.
So the Thai red chicken curry wasn't red. I did ask about that, but I didn't like it. It was really disappointing, and for me, probably the worst main of the whole week.
I think Jackie was really, really rude about their curry. If that had been one of my dishes, I'd have said, whoa there, love. Leave that on your plate. If you don't like it, don't eat it, but you don't need to offer it around.
I'm not going to get offended by anything that Jackie says or does, because that would be ridiculous. If I was going to try and please Jackie, that's never going to happen. I'd disappoint everyone else on the planet.
Is this a team effort, or did you have roles and responsibilities? Was somebody responsible for
one of
them?
Yeah, there's a team effort on Farms and Shopping, and this is one of my favourite dishes, so it was me that put this one together.
The pad thai, it had a nice flavour.
The pad thai?
Yeah, the noodles.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Pad thai.
Pad thai.
Pad Thai?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, you're so lovely. I love you.
Have you guys ever actually rowed? Have you ever actually had an argument?
No. We don't argue, honestly. And if I had seen a relationship like ours previously, I wouldn't have believed that these types of relationships exist.
How is that possible? How do people not row?
I don't believe that nobody's rowed in their whole relationship.
They've been, what, 2.5 years? 3.5 years? I never had a row.
Well, no.
Don't believe it.
I do believe it. If they said it, they that's probably true.
To Hannah and Lucy, because I think you two guys are amazing.
Thank you. I wanted to say that Simon develop this week a skills. Talk a sweet words, didn't happen before.
Has he told you he loves you today, Adita?
Oh, yeah, a lot of times.
Wow, Simon and Adita close together. That's worrying, isn't it?
Yeah, oh.
And with love in the air, there's just one final course to go.
Hey, apple pie.
Get your hand on my apple pie.
Well, that didn't last long. Here's Simon's homemade apple pie and custard.
The first time I've ever made fresh homemade custard vanilla.
Wow.
So this was this was my risk element.
I think the custard could have had slightly more vanilla. They've put it in there, so let's get it in there. Don't just tickle it, let's have it.
Yeah. In an ideal world, I'd have loved a bit more of a cinnamon taste in it, but there was the apple pie was lovely.
It's delicious. Can I have some more, please?
You may. Well, you
said Oliver Twist. Can I have some more, please?
You are more than welcome. I can't be more happy about how that went. Regardless of the result tonight, if I lose now, after that, I'll be pretty disappointed.
Yep, but you're not scoring.
For me, I'm erring towards 15, 16.
What's this? This is me winning dance.
Don't start celebrating just yet. Simon and Adita need 32 or more to win the grand.
Dan really liked the food tonight, and he thought it was better than Lucy and Hannah's food last night. For me personally, I preferred Lucy and Hannah's menu, so we have decided jointly on 14.
If we were scoring on the people, it would be 20, but we can't. We have to score it on the food. For that reason, we give it...
Hold on there. It's over to the host to reveal the winners.
Yay! Yay! Here we go. In third place, Simon and Adisa.
Wow, that's a shocker.
So it's down to you guys now. Who's won the money?
Good luck. Good luck. May the best couple win.
Yes.
And joint first.
Oh, wow!
Hannah and Lucy scored Simon and Adita 14, leaving them last.
Of course we won. We were always going to win, weren't we? And we did. Only half.
No!
Lovely job. Delighted. But also... a little bit robbed.
We'll take our share.
Time we didn't win, but I love you still.
I know you don't.
Mm.
For more on Come Dine With Me, head to the Channel 4 website. It's very funny and available as a box set on 4OD, so now you can binge-watch Friday Night Dinner. Simpsons next on 4, and with a beautiful, very famous admirer, Ned Flanders. Is about to become the envy of Springfield. I'll never tell.